शुक्लाम्बरग्रहं विष्णुं शिशुवर्णं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदनं ध्यायेत् सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तये. लेट दि गॉड गणेश गिव दि एनर्जी एंड बूस्ट अवर साइंस विद अनइंटरप्टेड इन्फॉर्मेशंस. द पर्पस ऑफ दिस लेक्चर सीरीज एज द टेक्नो आयुर्वेद विश टू मेक द आयुर्वेद एविडेंस बेस्ड मेडिसिन to establish and to propagate those evidences. And out of, we would like to have very specifically Kaya Chikitsa, Panchakarma, Dravyaguna and Rasa Shastra assistance is going to be taken. And I am inviting the eminent speakers all to speak over the different parts and subjects of the Ayurveda. Now, in fact, when we are looking at the Ayurveda, this Ayurveda seems to be quite comfortable for many people, but they feel still it is a home remedial measures rather than that of the evidence-based medicine. And whenever this Ayurveda is being recollected, we recollect the first and foremost rishis and sages, those who are trying to make ourselves, giving rise in the sloka format and in Sanskrit format. And later, the street vendors of the herbs. This is a very big pathetic situation in Ayurveda. Many a times it is being stated as the Ayurveda is at the crossroads. How come this Ayurveda is at the crossroads? Because the Ayurveda practicing by learning the Ayurveda is one thing. Ayurveda learning and Ayurveda practicing is the first modality. Whereas the second modality is incorporation of the allopathy techniques in Ayurveda and making an Ayurvedic practice. The third, of course, allopathy learning and allopathy practice is not at all concern of the Ayurveda at all. The fourth is nobody is going to do Ayurveda learning and allopathy practice. But very unfortunately, we are doing the same thing, learning the Ayurveda but practicing the allopathy. This entire scenario which we see, the common people are not thinking Ayurveda is a scientific medicine. Why do they have such sort of the feeling that they are not, this Ayurveda is not at all a scientific and it is only household remedies like. The culprit is in fact the Ayurveda physician himself. The scenario of the Ayurveda physician as they could not establish themselves. Much of the Ayurvedic people are from the middle classes. The learning of the Ayurveda itself is a big task and practicing Ayurveda itself is another big task. I still recollect, I joined in 1977 the Ayurveda BAMS and at that time, when the people were practicing the Ayurveda, we used to have in the market around 7,000 medicines available for the prescription. By the time I complete my post-graduation in 1989, I was getting around 700 to 800,000 medicines by name. But as on today, when I see any medicine, when I ask the medicine seller, the medical shop, they say it is not available. At this juncture, many of the people started making their own combinations and permutations of the Ayurveda based on the Rasa Panchaka of the Dravyaguna. Or otherwise, the people, those who have the knowledge of the metallic medicines and metallic purification systems, like Rasa Shastra experts, are going to make the Rasa Shastra Rasa medicines. And thereby these rasa medicines are going to be made out and useful. The question of quality of the rasa medicines available in the market is also a very big thing. Many of the companies previously they were manufacturing these medicines. Nowadays they are making these medicines as the medicines of the loan licensing. I invite Dr. Gopi Krishna as a rasa expert. And he is preparing lots of the medicines on his own, and he is distributing to the patients to whomsoever coming, and thereby he is getting the very beautiful results. Many a times I requested Dr. Gopi Krishna to provide these medicines for the rest of the people, those who want. But the question is, medicine preparation for himself is something different, and providing at a mass scale is also quite difficult. A person who is treating patients and manufacturing both the things simultaneously, it will be very difficult. He is called as a portly man. I welcome Dr. Gopi Krishna. Will you please on your screen so that the people can see and make out? Dr. Gopi Krishna. Okay, now he is unable to make out. Anyway, here what I would like to make out is Techno Ayurveda is committed for the tradition to bring to the technology. To bring to the technology the traditions, we have to understand first and foremost what is this tradition at all. We are lingering much more with the Tridoshas. We are speaking the Prakriti is based upon the Tridosha, Charidaka Prakriti. But ultimately we are landing with that of only a referral of the genetic material. This genetic material could be changed because of the geographical condition that has been accepted and made a research by the National Geographic Channel. What actually they made is, when they have come across the Mongolian Genghis Khan successors, the many people were claiming they are the Genghis Khan successors, and they started the genetical study over the successors of the Genghis Khan. They found M83 or 84 gene is mutated, and the rest of all the people were there. When they extended the study in the China, all over the China, the same mutated gene was there. The same thing was found all over the, all globally, and ultimately they have concluded, except one sample at a small island below the Africa was said to be found with a different gene. Otherwise, this is only one gene all over the globe which is spread out. Our Indian story speaks the same thing. India, when we have this, seven Prajapatis were there. The seven Prajapatis, out of that one Prajapati was successful, and who called as Daksha is a capable of spreading the people or generating the offsprings in a very big manner. That means almost all the global population as on today, what we have is the successors of the same Daksha Prajapati derived from the only one, and rest of the Prajapati's children or the successors would have gone with the wind, or they could not survive. Now the question of the Ayurveda. When we are looking this Ayurveda is basically is going to speak the two things which are dependent on the food itself. Dharmartha kama mokshanam arogyam mulamuttam. Out of the dharma, artha, kama, moksha, the arogya or the health sustenance is the most important thing. When we are making the health sustenance, for the health sustenance and survivability, we do require the food. The food is going to be the chaturvidham annapanam. The Charaka exclusively has given n number of the chapters over the how to take the food, what food has to be consumed, what variety of the food, how to prepare the food, and so on. And ultimately, the two varieties of the diseases which we are supposed to land on is the one is the Santarpanottha Vikara, second is the Apatarpanottha Vikara. That means the entire body, either the humors or the dhatus, that is dosha or the dhatu, both are dependent on the same factor of the nutrition and nourishment. Either the undernourishment or the overnourishment. If the undernourishment or the Apatarpana is there, the Santarpana or the Brahmana is to be made out. If there is a Brahmana or otherwise Santarpanottha Vikaras are there, where the Langana is being made. And that means the entire treatment scenario in Ayurveda is brought under only two categorization. One is the santarpanottha vikaras to be treated with the langhana and apatarpanottha vikaras to be treated with the santarpana. Thereby, the brahmana langhana managements are only the criteria. That means the first criteria in Ayurveda, which we are missing as on today, looking at the disease state, not on the dosha state, neither on the food state. Each and every disease is brought out or being developed either because of the, as a result of the santarpana or the apatarpana only. Thereby, we need to understand whether the individual disease, whichever is going to be of the brahmana to be made for the apatarpana diseases or otherwise, the langhana to be made for the santarpana disease. Stavulya is a santarpanottha vikara. Now, when we see, apart from, there is a Krimi Siddhanta also. Why the Krimi Siddhanta was denied by the Ayurveda people is, they were trying to kill this Krimi. It could be of the, there are so much of the description over the Krimi. We are speaking of the four varieties of the Krimis, very specifically out of that only the Purushija Krimis are most targeted. But what about the Raktaja Krimi and other Krimis which are there? That means there are different varieties of the Krimis which are basically classified into five areas. Apart from that, they were speaking about the Apsara, Rakshasa, Pisacha. Pisacha, by definition, it is going to be, Pisa means Mamsa, Pisacha means it eats the Mamsa. A virus or a bacteria which is going to eat the Mamsa is said as a Pisacha. The Krimi Siddhanta is there already in Ayurveda. But only one thing here is, we cannot totally kill or take out the bacteria. In fact, whatever the n number of the cells are there in our body, 10 times more than that of the viruses and bacteria are there in our body. We are living from the beginning with them. Why can't we live with the new viruses and bacteria? Why don't we make them accustomed with? This is what the technology has been made in Ayurveda. As we are going to see, the difference of the opinions of the either of the based chikitsa or the treatment based on the only dosha, prakriti. Deha prakriti and manasika prakriti both are going to be there with. When deha prakriti and manasika prakriti are there with, we have to understand this, how deha prakriti has to be dealt with and how this manasika prakriti has to be dealt with. Now, when we come across with the deha prakriti, we have the five. The five deha prakriti, the deha prakritis of the dvandaja vikaras, ekadoshaja, didoshaja, and tridoshaja, totally seven varieties of the deha prakritis are going to be there with. Are we treating according to the deha prakriti? Many people are going to see, even I speak the Tantu Nadi Vijnana, Techno Ayurveda, specialized Nadi Vijnana. Based upon the Nadi, I am going to prescribe the Panchakarma. That is the limitation of that particular Nadi. In that, there is a common question, how the Prakriti is to be assessed. Okay? We are going to assess the Prakriti. After assessing Prakriti, is there any Prakriti-based medicine has been prescribed? Now, Vyadhi Prakriti is different. When there is a Vyadhi Prakriti has to be treated in a different way than that of the Deha Prakriti. The medicines are being prescribed based upon the Vyadhi Prakriti, but not on the Deha Prakriti. That means assessment of the Deha Prakriti is useless. Except one point, Tulya Dosha, Tulya Prakriti, if suppose a person who is having Kapha Prakriti, having a Kapha Vyadhi is easily treatable. Atulya Prakritis are going to be difficult. A kapha Prakriti person who is having Vata Prakriti Madhumeha, it is difficult to be treated. Whereas Kapha Prakriti can be treated very easily. There it is the only one reference it is going to come. Apart from Dhatu involvement has been said. It is said for the two diseases very specifically. The first one is the Jvara and second one is the Kushta. These two are said to be the inclusion of the Dhatus. That means, is the other diseases are not going to be at the Dhatu level? Rasagata Madhumeha, Raktagata Madhumeha, Mamsagata Madhumeha, Medhogata Madhumeha, Sukragata Madhumeha. We can make it out. When we are making this classification of the diseases, Sushruta sevenfold classification is said to be the one of the best one, which is going to be fall under the Ajhatmika, Adhidaivika, Adhibhautika Vyadhis. This Ajhatmika, Adhidaivika, Adhibhautika Vyadhis are subdivided to seven. They are of the Saptavidham. The seven are subdivided into two. That means there are 14 varieties of the classification of the diseases. That means each and every disease, even the sub-disease, if suppose we are taking the Meha, Prameha, there are Vimsati Pramehas. All these Vimsati Prameha, for example, we are taking the Madhumeha as a Vata Jameha. When we are taking this Vataja Meha, even this Vataja Meha is going to be the Adhibara Pravritta. Juvenile diabetes, we are already having a terminology. When we have this example of the juvenile diabetes, we have to understand whether it is of the Pitruja or Matruja. A Pitruja is the referral to that of the genetics, and whereas Matruja is referral to that of the mitochondria. If the mother is having the diabetes, Madhumeha, it is somehow curable because it is at the level of the mitochondria. Whereas, a Madhumeha which is of the Pitruja in nature, genetical will be difficult because we may not be able to mutate it. But Ayurveda has suggested even such sort of the diseases which are of the genetical to be altered by making the mutation. Especially the Sukra, when it is going to be mandled through the different herbs like Nal Pamada or otherwise Chatukshira Vrukshas, Panchakshira Vrukshas. This Chatukshira Vrukshas and Panchakshira Vrukshas are very specifically understood as the genetical alterations which are going to be made out. There are some of the specific herbs which we have where we can use the combination permutation to mutate the genetics of an individual. For example, a parent is having diabetes, but we do not want this parental diabetes should not be carried to that of the successor children. At that time, whatever the kriyas which we are doing, the preparation for the pregnancy, for the male and female both are necessary. When we are preparing, we are making the sodhana to them. Later on, the sustenance and genetical mutation and regularization. After genetical sustenance and mutation, when it is going to be done, we are going to make the proper and good progeny to be developed. Thereafter, there will be a selection of the child, which we are going to see even, either the male child or the female child, based on the Pumsavana Kriya. Many a times, even the Pumsavana Kriya and the whatever the herbs which we are using under the Pumsavana Kriya also competent to make the genetical mutations. They are the specific medicines which are going to make the mutation of the gender. By birth, each and every person is a female at the time when they are going to form as a zygote. Based upon the mother hormones, tolerances and richness, if the testosterone is very rich, then we are going to have a male child. And if it is of the estrogen, then it is going to be of the female child. Here, many people are going to ask whether I am going to get the male child or female child. Then any lady is going to be pregnant, just make a test of the hormones through the blood test. Whether she is rich of the female hormones, estrogens, or rich of the testosterone, thereby you can just say the fetus is going to be either the male or female. The Adipala Pravrutta Vyadhis, when we are going to speak out, many diseases which we are going to come, and thereby the treatment with that of the Panchakshiri Vrikshas is the one of the best thing. Even Ayurveda has suggested some of the medicines very specifically to be used as a contraception also. Tulsi is one of the best contraceptive. When the people are going to consume Tulsi regularly, the semen is going to be get decreased. Thereby the natural contraception is going to be there with. It happens even with the females also. Second is the Janmabala Pravruttas. Janmabala Pravruttas are related to that of the food. When this Janmabala Pravruttas are going to be there with, Ahara Viharas both are to be considered in the Janmabala Pravruttas. It could be of the Kanja, Pangu, Andhatva, Jachandhatva, Badratva, Moka, Mirmira, Dardada, etc. These are going to be get developed. Say, we are not going to allow these pregnant ladies into the eclipse because of the radiation. Now, in cities especially, there is lots of the pollution and the radiation. The pollution of the air, pollution of the light, pollution of the weather conditions, all these things which are going to be seen, they are going to cause lots of things. Out of the infertility couples, the majority population of the infertility exist only in big cities and big townships. This is a very fact. There could be two reasons. One is the pollution, and second is the work tensions and stress. The Janmabala Pravrutta Vyadhis are to be tackled once again with respect to that of the disease and also as Brahmana Langara Chikitsa. The third is the Doshabala Pravrutta. When we are looking at the Doshabala Pravrutta, the Apachya Ahara Viharas are going to be the list of the individual diet. Here the depletion. See, Susuta very beautifully said, Vruddha Rasaritavya, Rasa Vardhaitavya, Kupita Niraharitavya, Samaha Paripalya Itikechit. This is the only total principle. Whatever is less, increase it. Whatever is increased, decrease it. Whatever is in normal state, maintain it. Whatever is mitigated, remove it. Now this principle of Doshabala Pravrutta, when we are looking at, this Doshabala Pravrutta is going to give either the Sharirika Doshas or the Manasika Doshas. We have the many medicines related with that of the body and also psychosomatic disorders as a third classification. When this psych and somatic both are going to be there with, we have to make the proper treatments of the Langana and Brahmana Chikitsas. Brahmana, of course, we can make it out. Langana Chikitsa, when we are making, Chatushprakara Samsuddhi is the Charaka statement. When this Vamana Virechana, Nasya and Vasti, out of these Purna Sodhakas are only Vamana and Virechana, whereas the Vasti and Nasya are the Ardha Chikitsa, Ardha Sodhaka, because they make the Brahmana also. Vasti Ardha Chikitsa, it is a very big question in even in the UGPG also. Because there is a Brahmana Chikitsa done by the Vasti, that's why it cannot be said as a Sodhana Chikitsa. Sodhana means Langana. After the Doshabala Pravruttas, we have the Sankhata Bala Pravruttas. This is Adi Bhautika Vyadhi. Somebody is going to met with an accident or injury, the traumatological conditions, they are very clear with the traumatological condition. Trauma care is very specifically made out, or otherwise by the even with that of the animal stings or the bites, etc. Also, they are external in origination, thereby they are treated accordingly according to the trauma care. Sanghata Parapravutta. after the sanghata para pravrutta kala para pravrutta. This kala para pravrutta vyadhis are going to be because of the seasonal changes which we are going to see with. When we see this seasonal changes according to the ritu, it was stated that according to the ritu we have to treat. The sodhana is one of the best thing which we are going to make out. Thereby, the seasonal vasanta vamana, sharad virechana, which we are speaking, is a seasonal regimen to protect our body. Whether we are following this like a pediatric vaccination chart or like a therapeutic chart of the diabetic protection, we have to make out a proper normal health maintenance through Ayurveda with a chart. A normal person who is having in a, according to the season, what is to be done in what sort of the periodicity. As per disease, it was a very big question. When I was working with the Vartha, at the time, 2012, when I joined, it was only Vasanta Vamana. 10, 15, 20 Vamanas were done within these 6 to 7 days. And after that, in the total year, there were no Vamana at all. I said, a disease can be treated at any time. This is for the healthy people. Thereafter, you don't believe, every month we used to have not less than 50 to 70 Vamanas. Sometimes in one day, even 5 to 7 Vamanas also. We were scared of the rooms even. What I just want to try to tell you is we need a specific catalog and demarcation of the how to protect the health. Thereby, a healthy person has to be made in the Vasanta Ritu Vamana. Make out your patients. Make a database. Ask them. Tell them. And there is one more question of making it. Whether this, when we are making the Vasanta Vamana or the any Vamana Karma, whether it is to be requiring 3 days, 5 days, 7 days of the Snehapana. According to my experience, if at all the dosha is leena, when the deep-rooted dosha is there and chronic disease is there, we require 7 days of the Snehapana, otherwise we do not require. 5 days also, it's a middle area. 3 days is already a little chronic. Otherwise, what I am trying to do with this Snehapana is, I just take the weight of the patient. The weight of the patient is 68 kgs. Very nice. 70 ml of the Snehapana has to be given. If suppose 95 kgs, 100 ml of the Snehapana to be given at once. And the in the night, Kafotkleshakara Ahara. Many a times when the Kafotkleshakara Ahara means, always people are getting the Trikanda or otherwise Dahi. Okay, they can be taken. But there are so many other medicines which are the condiments and foods which are going to be said as a Kafotkleshakaras. We have to make the use of this Kafotkleshakara Dravyas. Instantaneously, how this Kafotklesha can be made. And those things can be given out of curd and the Srikanda is one of the best things. When the people are going to consume this the next day morning, when we are making the Vamana, it was said to be the Vamana Karma, whether it has to be done before to the sunrise. Usually this tradition has been started from the Kerala. It is always suggested when a person is comfortably defecated, after the defecation only you have to make the Vamana Karma. If a person is not defecated, the mala is going to come upwards. This is going to cause another problem also. Why we are, the patient is not taken proper food. If suppose, The Vamana Karma has to be performed and patient is not defecated properly. What to be done? I always suggest, give him a lukewarm enema, let him pass the stools. After that, you conduct the Vamana, how you feel and how better Vamana is being performed. It is going to give an exclusively a Pittanta Vamana with the total kapha nirahana can be observed after the proper defecation of the patient. Otherwise, if the already patient is having lots of the bloating, that is the reason why the many of the patients are going to make 3 to 4 times defecation while making the Vamana Karma. What does it mean? We are not giving while making the Vamana Karma the Ubhaya Dosha Haratvam, Urdhva and Adho. It is only Urdhva Dosha Haratvam. For that, the bowls are to be kept clean before to induct the Vamana Karma. Now this Vyapanna Ritukruta, Avyapanna Ritukruta, both disorders has to be made out. In the winter, getting the common cold and making the nasya is a common. Vyapanna Ritukruta. In the summer, there is a cold. It is Avyapanna Ritukruta. We have to check out why it is. Corona was there in the total year. People were scared by the winter. It is going to flare up. It did not flare up. It is, whether it is a Vyapanna Ritukruta or the Avyapanna Ritukruta, we have to reclassify our surroundings, our situation, whatever we are going to see. Principles are the perfect. We need not always, all the time, only to stick on to that of the Ayurveda slokas which are being given 2000 to 4000, they say. But according to my carbon dating of the sloka pattern and the references, it is about the Ramayana Kala, approximately 11 to 15,000 years ago, which has been written. This geographical conditions of the 11 to 15,000 years back, how they were and how today we have, thereby we have to change ourselves accordingly. This is what the Vagbhada says. According to the time, you have to change yourself. If not, you cannot treat properly the patient. Charakasu chikitsate, I too accept. Charaka has given very good principles. The principles has to be followed, not the verdicts. When these verdicts are going to be observed, these verdicts are going to give lots of the confusion also sometimes. Thereby, the Vyapanna Ritukruta and Avyapanna Ritukruta chikitsas, when we are making it out, we have to make ourselves very comfortably how to be adaptative. This adaptation, if some principle from the modern is said to be good enough, applying that principle into Ayurveda is not a wrong. And one of the question is, ultimately, whether you are giving a crocin tablet or the Chitamsu Rasa is the question. The next comes as a Daiva Bala Pravritta Vyadhis. Out of the sevenfold classification of the Shushruta, when we see, we get lots of the things. This diabetes is the Vyapanna Ritukruta, Avyapanna Ritukruta also. How the diabetes is Vyapanna Ritukruta and Avyapanna Ritukruta? We see, a gestational diabetes for a pregnant lady. That is to be happen accordingly. Thereby, a person who is not at all eating, I take only one chapati till my glucose levels are 350. This becomes Avyapanna Ritukruta. Under the Daiva Bala Pravritta Vyadhis, we say Devata, unknown, pyrexia of unknown origin. To say PUO, pyrexia of unknown origin, is beautiful. But if we say a disease of unknown origin is of the Daiva Bala Pravritta, we don't know how it has been happened. Probably it could be because of the Vijud Asinikruta or the Pisacha. The two classifications which has been made. Where some cause is being seen, electrical shock, like or the lightning, or something happened suddenly, we don't know. The second is said to be the pisacha adhikrita. That means either the bacteria or the virus. Now the present COVID situation, what we are facing, that could be of a daiva bala pravrutta vyadhi. This is of the pisacha adhikrita and avyapanna rutu pratam vyadhi. And thereby, we have to check it out. If suddenly a person who is going to be diabetic, how come it is going to be? We don't know. He is not at all, he is very regular, pious and so on. I have seen some of the priests are very pious people, those who do not smoke or drink or do anything. At the 25-30 years of the age, they get the heart attacks. And at the 25-30 age, they get the cancer even. How come this is possible? What makes these people? Is it is genetical or triggering mechanisms are there in the environment or the food or anywhere? We have to check it out. And the last swabhava bala pravrutta vyadhis, when we are looking at this swabhava, is we are getting the hunger, thirst and so on. When we are hungry, we don't eat. When we are thirsty, we don't make it out. At the time, the dhatu perishment is going to take place. They are going to give the diseases also. So we have to make out and understand either the kalakrita or akalakrita. A person who is getting changes of the old age when he is 20 years and all the white hairs are there and vali palitas are there, then that means it is really a problem. Getting hunger is normal. But getting white hair at the age of the 10 or 15 is not common. These swabhavapala pravruttas are going to be of the kalakrata or the akalakrata vyadhis could be made out. When we have this kalakrata, akalakrata vyadhis, all these disorders of the classification which we are making it out, we have to treat accordingly. Now the Techno Ayurveda is intended to make the tradition to bring to the technology. Thereby, I wish this series of the lectures, here I am inviting the different people, those who are good enough to speak their own subject of the Dravya Guna, Rasa Shastra, Kaya Chikitsa, Panchakarma, etc. also. And many people have been requesting the 5:30 to 6:30 is a clinic hour on Saturday is difficult. As if it is going to be made on the Saturday evening, 9:30 to 10:30 p.m. Thereby we come back from the clinic and we can actively participate. I thought this is also could be made out. And the next day is Sunday, thereby we can sleep for another 1 hour also extra. Usually what I see, many people are on WhatsApp or on the things, even up to 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock also. Thereby 9:30 to 10:30 timings of the Techno Ayurveda series is going to be made out. I request one and all to contact me personally along with a topic which you want to speak. Thereby, I can make arrangement of this platform to have an interaction and we can speak one to another with a specified topic of the around 40 minutes. So the time tenure is from the next session of the Techno Ayurveda is from 9:30 p.m. to the 10:30 p.m. And thereby you make yourself tuned with this particular time. And every Saturday we'll try to make it out. If at all possible, if not possible, I'll be intimating you. I'll be giving you time to time the speaker and also the person who is going to speak what topic, and thereby we are going to make a continuous health education, Ayurveda health education through the Techno Ayurveda platform. This is what my intention is. Today I started with as an inaugural, and you people, your opinions, suggestions are requested. You can discuss on the Techno Ayurveda on the Telegram, and if at all anybody wants to join first Telegram and type Techno Ayurveda, then you will be getting the all the things which are going to be displayed, and you can just put join and you can join into the service of Techno Ayurveda. So I am very much thankful for the aspirant people, those who are here. And if at all there are any questions, let us have a discussion and thereby we can make it out. You can unmute yourself, and if at all you have a question, you can ask a question so that we'll make it out. I'll try to post these videos on the on the YouTube so that it can be seen by the other people and also they can enjoy it. I request, if at all there are any questions, we can make it out. You may be feeling whatever I am speaking, say for example, when I speak about the Vamana Karma, it is out of my experience which I am speaking, out of the, from 1982 onwards I am practicing. 92, 2002, 2012, and within another 2 years, I'll be completing the 40 years. I was looking, if at all a person is not going to be properly making his natural adjust completed, undertaking for the Vamana Karma or the Virechan Karma or any other karmas is most useless and it doesn't give a proper treatment. Adi Sodhana, Kriya, what we are expecting. So, I request your questions. Quickly we'll answer and we'll close the session. You can unmute and place your question.
Sir, it was a great session, sir. How minutely, sir, you have explained about everything, sir. I am very much blessed to have lecture from you, sir.
Thank you. But any doubts or questions?
No doubts.
Okay. You can open your video screen and unmute yourself and ask your question. I do not take anybody's individual name. Whomsoever wants to make out, you please make it out. From next, we are going to be on Saturday, 9:30 to 10:30 p.m. So it is comfortable for the everybody. They can have their food and all and comfortably relax and hear the lecture. Next time onwards, we'll be going for very specific topics. Topic will be announced well in advance.
Okay, sir. Okay. Right. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Anybody have any question? Hope everybody is comfortable.
Yes. And
thank you very much and see you in the next session, Techno Ayurveda 2nd.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.